Good morning, all of you. I'm Dr. Pradeep Kumar, working as Assistant Professor in St. Peter's Engineering College, Autonomous, Hyderabad. Today, we will start Unit 2, that is Molecular Structure and Theories of Bonding. In this unit, you have the contents, that is, first we will discuss about the introduction about the unit, that is, introduction about the molecular structure and theories of bonding, and what are the atomic orbitals, what are the molecular orbitals, how the formation of the molecular orbitals can take place, what is the method is there to explain the formation of the molecular orbitals. That is, in your syllabus you have LCAO method, linear combination of atomic orbitals, to explain the formation of the molecular orbitals from the atomic orbitals. The next topic is how to draw the molecular orbital energy level diagrams for the homonuclear diatomic molecules. Okay, the next topic is how to draw the molecular orbital energy level diagrams for the homo diatomic molecules. In your syllabus specifically, you have oxygen, nitrogen and fluorine. We have O2, N2 and F2, isn't it? And after that, you have one more topic, that is crystal field theory, CFT. Okay, crystal field theory. In this topic, you are going to learn about the salient features of the crystal field theory and its applications. Okay, in addition to that, you have the splitting pattern, the different splitting patterns of the transition metals in octahedral geometry, tetrahedral geometry and square planar geometries. Okay, then you have one more topic, that is band structures. Okay, what are the band structures, how the band structures formation can take place, how many types of the materials are there according to the conductivity, isn't it? We have three types of materials, we already know, that is the insulators are there, conductors, semiconductors, isn't it? And the doping effect, the doping effect in the solids, effect of doping on the conductance, isn't it? These topics we will discuss in this unit 2, sorry, molecular structure and theories of bonding. Okay, first, before entering to the main subject, first we need to have an idea about the fundamentals or basics of the molecule. Okay, here generally the molecules are made up from the atoms, isn't it? Atom. What is atom? Atom is a Greek word. Actually, it is a Greek word that means indivisible. Indivisible. Atom is a Greek word that means indivisible, isn't it? Yeah, molecules are constructed from the different atoms. Atom means here indivisible unit. Atom is a indivisible unit, isn't it? We cannot divide, isn't it? This atom, we cannot divide, isn't it? That is known as indivisible unit. Okay, atom. Here, actually, atom have three fundamental particles. Atom will have the three fundamental particles. Those are electron, proton and neutron. Isn't it? Atom will have electron, proton and neutron, which are having the different masses and different charges. These three are having the different masses and different charges, isn't it? Yeah. Here, actually electron, we already know, electron is having the negative charge and proton is having the positive charge and neutron is not having any charge, isn't it? It's a neutral one, isn't it? It's a neutral one. There is no any charge on the neutron. Okay, these are the three fundamental components are having the atom, isn't it? Yeah, actually coming to the structure of the atom, we need have an fundamental basic idea about the structure of the atom here. In this atom, actually you have in the center we have the proton and neutron. Proton is in the center of the atom. You have the proton, that is positive charge, and neutron, isn't it? This is known as nucleus. This is known as nucleus. This is known as nucleus. Okay. And in the center we have the nucleus, that means positive charge, and we have neutron. And around this nucleus, actually we have the electron density. Around this nucleus, here we have electron density. This is the electron density. Electron is not a fixed particle, isn't it? Electron is not a fixed, it is not having the fixed area. Actually, electron is a movable part, movable area, movable particle, isn't it? Electron is, we already know, electron is a wave natured particle, isn't it? It's always movable. So this area actually is known as the electron. This area actually known as electron. Okay. Now this is the basic idea about the structure of the atom. In the atom, actually we have the proton and neutron in the center, which is called as nucleus, isn't it? And around this nucleus we have the electron density, which is having the negative charge, isn't it? Around the nucleus we have here electron density, that is electron. This is the idea about the atom structure. Okay. Yeah. Next we have orbital. What is mean by the orbital? Orbit means a, it's a circle, isn't it? It's a circle, orbit. So here, according to the quantum mechanics or atomic theory, the orbital is a mathematical function of the wave natured and particle natured electron, isn't it? Orbital is a mathematical function of an electron, which is having to explain the particle nature and wave like behavior of the electron, isn't it? Simply we can say the probability of finding of an electron in an atom is known as orbital. Orbital means, simply we can say, probability of finding of an electron in an atom. Here, what is the finding of an electron? Probability of finding of an electron is around the nucleus, isn't it? It is around the nucleus. So this area is known as orbital. Now we have different orbital, that is atomic orbital is there, molecular orbital is there. What is the difference between the atomic orbital and molecular orbitals? These things can we can discuss in detail. Okay, this is the introduction or fundamental idea about the atom and orbital. Okay, first you have to get an idea about the atom and orbital. Okay,
yeah.
Next, coming to our topic, that is, first you have the molecular orbital theory. Yeah, coming to the main topic, that is molecular orbital theory. Molecular orbital theory. It is one of the important topics in your syllabus, which we can expect questions from this topic from the examinations. Okay, this is molecular orbital theory. Actually, to explain the molecular structures and characteristics of the molecules, previously we have some theories, that is Lewis theory and valency shell electron pair theory, VSEPR, and valency bond theory. Actually, previously we have Lewis valency shell electron pair theory and valency bond theory to explain the different structures of the different molecules and characteristics of the molecules. But these theories have failed to explain the in detail information about the molecules. These theories actually fail to explain the in detail information about the different molecules, isn't it? So that's why at the time the Mullikan, the scientist Mullikan, had proposed the molecular orbital theory. The molecular orbital theory has been proposed by the Mullikan to explains the formation of chemical bond and the relative bond strengths and magnetism nature, or it may be paramagnetic or diamagnetic. Actually, the Mullikan had proposed the MOT theory to explain the formation of chemical bond and their relative bond strengths, and whether the molecule is having the paramagnetic nature or diamagnetic nature, and whether the molecule is stable or unstable, isn't it, etc. To explain these type of characteristics of a chemical bond or a molecule, the MOT theory proposed, isn't it? These are the things we are going to discuss in the molecular orbital theory. Here we have some main features of the molecular orbital theory. Yeah, here we have some main features of the theory. Main features of theory. In these main features, first point is the atomic orbitals can combine. Atomic orbitals can combine and overlap to form new orbitals is known as molecular orbitals. Coming to the first point, here the atomic orbitals are going to combine or overlap to form new orbitals, which we can call molecular orbitals. Okay, here the different atomic orbitals are going to combine or overlap and to form new orbitals, which we can call molecular orbitals. Okay, as a result, what happens here? Actually, these atomic orbitals are going to lose their individual identity. Here, as a result, the atomic orbitals are going to lose their individual identity. That means, actually, atomic orbitals, as we discussed in the earlier, here actually atomic orbitals are having, each atomic orbital is having only one nucleus, isn't it? Each atomic orbital is having only one nucleus. But coming to the molecular orbitals, here a molecular orbitals, each molecular orbital is having two or more nucleus. The molecular orbitals are having two or more nucleus, isn't it? So that's why in this way the atomic orbitals are going to lose their individual identity. Initially, this atomic orbitals is having, each orbital is having one nucleus, but when the molecular orbitals formed, these are having the two or more different nucleus are present. That means here the electron will revolve in the atomic orbitals on the only one nucleus, while in the molecular orbitals electron or can revolve in the two or more different nucleus. This is the main point of the theory, the first point of the theory. And coming to the second point, actually the formed molecular orbitals are equal to the participated atomic orbital in the overlapping. That means if the two atomic orbitals formed going to combine to form molecular orbitals, how many molecular orbitals will get? Only two molecular orbitals. The number of formed molecular orbitals are equals to the number of participated atomic orbitals. Okay, now see here the formed number of molecular orbitals are equals to the participated, that means in the overlapping process, the participated number of atomic orbitals. Okay, if the three atomic orbitals are formed in the overlapping, how many molecular orbitals we will get? We will get three molecular orbitals. If the combining process or overlapping process, if the four atomic orbitals is participated, how many molecular orbitals we will get? We will get four molecular orbitals. That means the number of formed molecular orbitals are equals to the number of participated atomic orbital, number of overlapping atomic orbitals, isn't it? And coming to the next point, here each molecular orbital is having maximum 2 electrons. Each molecular orbital is having how many electrons? 2 electrons with opposite spins. With opposite spins. Here each molecular orbital is having 2 electrons with opposite spins. Isn't it?
Yeah.
See once, coming to the main features of the theory, the first point or main point is, here the atomic orbitals are going to combine or overlap to form new orbitals which we can call molecular orbitals. As a result, what happens here? Here the atomic orbitals are going to lose their individual identity. That means initially these atomic orbitals are having, each atomic orbital is having only one nucleus. When the molecular orbitals formed, each molecular orbitals are having more than two or more than two nucleus, isn't it? And next point, the number of formed molecular orbitals are equals to the number of combined or overlap or participated atomic orbitals. And last point, that is, each molecular orbital is having the maximum capacity of 2 electrons with opposite spins, isn't it?
Yeah.
According to these 3 points, we can describe the molecular orbital as, the molecular orbital is a polycentric space in region, and which are having the 2 or more atoms in a molecule with maximum 2 electrons with opposite spins. According to above 3 points, here we can describe the molecular orbital as, molecular orbital is a polycentric space in region, 2 or more atoms in a molecule which are having the maximum 2 electrons capacity with opposite spins, isn't it? This is the main features of the MOT theory. These are the main features of the MOT theory. And how the formation of the molecular orbitals can take place, if you see here, in this case, to form the molecular orbitals, here the atomic orbitals should have an comparable energy. The atomic orbitals should have comparable energy and similar orientation. To form the molecular orbitals, here the atomic orbitals should have the comparable energy and similar orientation. What are they? If you see, example, one s orbital of atomic. Here we are discussing one s atomic orbital. One s atomic orbital can overlap and can form the molecular orbital. One s orbital of the one atom and one s orbital of the one atom will overlap, can overlap and form molecular orbital. But 1s orbital of the one atom and 2s orbital of the another atom will not participate in the overlapping and will not form the molecular orbital. Isn't it? 1s and 1s, these are having the same energies, isn't it? So that's why those are participated in the overlap and can form the molecular orbital. But in the case of 1s and 2s, will not participate in the overlap and will not form the molecular orbital, because here the energy will be different. The energies of the 1s and 2s is different, isn't it? So that's why this overlapping, this type of overlapping cannot take place, isn't it? And coming to the orientation, if you see here, px, the px, px, that means 2px, 2px of the different atoms can overlap and can form the molecular orbitals, isn't it? 2px of the one atom and 2px of the another atom can come close together and can overlap and form the molecular orbital. But 2px of the one atom and 2py or 2pz, 2px, 2py and 2pz of the another atom will not participate in the formation of the molecular orbital. Even though the energies will be similar, here these type of formation of the molecular orbital cannot take place because the orientation will be different here, isn't it? The orientation will be different here, even though similar energies. So this type of combining of the atomic orbitals also cannot take place and will not form the molecular orbitals. This is the one point, that is, the atomic orbitals should have the comparable energy and similar orientation to form the molecular orbitals, isn't it? So that's why here 1s orbital of the different atoms can overlap and form molecular orbital, but 1s, 2s overlapping is not occurring here due to the energy difference. And here 2px, 2px can form the molecular orbital, but 2px with 2py and 2pz cannot form the molecular orbital, even though having the similar energy. Here the orientation will be different, isn't it? This is the overlapping limitations we have in the atomic orbitals. Okay.